Hello everyone, this is Kamal Bunkar and today is fourth day of 50 days Android course. So in today's session we will work on login form. So we will create a simple login form, okay, and we will try to make user login through it, okay. First we will try simple login form. After that we will work on material design login form. So let's do it. So I have created this project, name is login form design, okay. The project is blank, so let me okay, so this is our blank activity. So what I am going to do today, I just want to show you. So in today's session we will create a form in which I will put a name field, so that will be edit text, and I will put a password field, or either I will just use a name and phone number, okay. So this is the material design, but first we will start with the simple design, okay. So I will try to put a logo there, okay, and button and forget button, okay. So this is I am going to create this type of design, okay, but this is the advanced design. So after first simple design, then we will create this type of view, okay. So now come to our Android Studio, okay. So first of all we have to set our main layout, okay. So for that one I am using a linear layout because all the item is in vertical manner. Linear layout is very easy to handle, so that's why most of the time I use linear layout. Okay, so linear layout, yes, I want linear layout, so call it what happened. Actually I am working on system from morning, that's why it is become very slow. So, okay, so just remove this text view, we don't need this text view. Okay, so first I want a logo, okay, and then I will create two edit text and two text view also for name and phone number, okay. So first I want a image view that will be logo of our app, okay. So you have to create five different size of your logo, okay. So if you want a smallest size, so start with the 36 dp, okay, then next size will be 48 dp, 48 by 48, then 72 by 72, and then 92 by 92, okay. Like that you have to go. Otherwise if you want some little big logo, so then use normally 48, start with the 72 by 72 width image. Okay, so this is the image view. So I want wrap content, and I want my image to be 72 dp only. Okay. And Android, I think I have to close this one, so then it will give me the access. Okay, so Android, I'm going to select the source. So right now I have only one image, so I will use it as a default Android icon. Source, src source. Okay, so right now I have only one image, so just use MipMap. Okay, and I want this logo to be in horizontal center. Okay, so Android gravity to be, layout gravity will be horizontal center. Okay, and I want some margin from top. Okay, so top margin will be 40 dp. So first I will try with 40 dp, then we will change it as we require. Okay, okay. So now I want a text view. Okay, then below that I will put a edit text. Okay, so text view will be, so the name as the type name or name here like that, or simply name. Okay, so text view, or I will use side by side, so that will be good. So I just use as a name, and user will type there. Okay, so there he will type. So just use the linear layout, then it will be good. Okay, so again use the linear layout, match parent. Okay, height will be wrap content, and I want orientation will be Android orientation will be horizontal. Okay, so this is it. Just put this edit text inside it. Okay, so the height will be wrap content. Okay, width will be wrap content, height will be wrap content, Android text. So I am just writing their name. You have to use string.xml file and type there. Okay, because if I do all these things, then it will take a lot of time. So padding, I just want 5 dp padding. Okay, and I want edit text beside this text view, so use edit text. This is also a wrap content, Android the id. Okay, id is text name. Okay, so this is the id, and you can use hint also. Hint will be type name. Okay, and I want some distance between these two. Okay, text view, so I just put some margin from left side, so it will be 20 dp. Okay, so just have a look. Okay, so there you can see logo is there, because main layout orientation is by default horizontal, so we have to define it. Android orientation is vertical. So this is it. I want this to be in center. So I am going to put the gravity in layout. Okay. So if you put gravity inside the layout, so it will arrange item in center position. Okay. So I am using gravity only. So inside this layout, whatever item is there, they all will be go in center position. Okay. So I just want horizontal center. So now you can see all item in center position, okay. So same thing I am doing with the phone number. So for that one I am going to copy this and I will change the some text, okay. So there I want phone number, so phone, so this will be phone type, phone number, okay. Phone number only, not this. Okay, so put some padding margin between all these things and I will use some color. Okay, so first I am going to put some margin. So Android margin, margin top to be 20 dp, okay. Same with this layout, so Android margin top to be 40 dp, okay. So this is it, okay. So this is a background color is white, so I just want to show you. So okay, so there is a website name as Color Hacks. Okay, there you can find the very good combination of color. So basically it is a plates. Okay, so let me just, okay, so if you want color, so you can pick from there. Okay, there are so many color and contrast color is too there. Okay, so I want some black or some little bit creamy brown. So okay, so I am just take this one, I want this color. Okay, so there are also so many website that will provide you a good color combination that you can use in your app. Okay, but don't mix the color, use the proper plating, so then it will be good. So set the background color as brown. Okay, so I'm directly using there, but okay, so there you can see the text color is black, so I have to change it, so this that way it will be so Android text color I want a pure white, so pure white color is there. Okay, just copy it. Okay, and okay, so this is a hint color also, we have to change hint color also. So Android text hint color, so text hint color. Okay, so I have to use some little bit fat color, not pure white. I can book and pick this one, so that will be good. Or use a little light. Okay. There it is. Okay. So this is it, and copy it, paste it. Okay. So this is now. Okay, so now we want some button, one button too. So when I will click on that button, I will get value from this edit text. So we will get phone number and phone name of user. Okay, so for that one, create a simple button. Okay, button will be wrap content, Android ID is button submit. Okay, just put a name, Android text is login. Okay, and I want text color to be white, so Android text color to be white. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, and I want it to be in center position, so Android layout gravity will be center horizontal. Okay, so this is my button. This is a very ordinary button. Okay, so I want this button will be a rounded corner button. Okay, so I just want to this shape will be a little bit rounded. So what you have to do, whenever you want a rounded corner, okay, so go to this folder and create a new XML file. Okay, so go there and create a drawable resource. Okay, so name it as we want a rounded corner, so just name is okay, so just click okay. So now I want a shape that will be in round, so use a shape keyword. Okay, shape. Okay, now inside it you can use the property as the radius. Okay, so there you can see corner. Okay, so there is a corner, click on it, and when you write the Android, so it will tell you, pop up you the these three options. Okay, so if you want only bottom left side will be a rounded corner, or you want only bottom side will be in a rounded way, so you can use these two properties. Okay, or if you want both side to be in rounded corner, so use direct radius. Okay, so I want all the four side to be in rounded corner. Okay, so just put 10 or 5 dp, whatever you want. Okay, and just close it. Okay, so there is another option that if you want color in your shape, okay, so you can use the stroke. Okay, or don't use the stroke, directly use the solid, so that will be good. Okay, so Android color, so there provide whatever color you want. So just look on the side there, if I want button color to be, so where is my plate? So I just want this one, this one, okay, or you can choose any one. So I am using this plate. So this is it. So I am just taking it, okay, and put this value and close this solid tag, okay. Now come to the our XML file, and I want this to be changed. So in button, what you have to do, Android set background, okay, and select this rounded corner as a background, so it will change your button design, okay. Where is rounded corner, okay. So let's have a look on it. So there is a issue. What issue? Name expected solid color. What is? So there is problem. One color has. It is good. Line 8 name expected. Background garble. Wait, what happened? What is this tribal rounded corner? I think I have to minimize it, then it will work. Okay. No. Save, and save is closed. The XML file is included. Okay. So I think there. Let me try with the stroke too. So maybe. So color is what? Okay. And anything else? Let me check it, whether it is working or not. Background. Okay, so driver rounded corner. Still there is problem. Okay, when we will run, then we will see what problem is there. Okay, so maybe sometime this view is not correct. It shows the error, but actually it's working. Okay, so we will try it. Okay. Okay, so. There is button, and now one more thing that I want forget the password, something that, so you can create a text view. Okay, so this will be again wrap content Android text, not color, text only. Okay, so forgot password. Okay, Android ID. Okay, so I just put some ID txt for God, okay, and put margin to be Android margin top to be 20 dp, and again it will be in center, so Android gravity will be center horizontal. Okay, so now make the color as the white. Android text color has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Okay, so actually this is the not gravity, this is the layout gravity. Okay, so this is it. Now try to run this code, and after that I will put the Java code. Okay, so we will perform on click button event on button, and we will try to match the username password. Okay, so it takes time, so just yesterday we created project, so what was the name? Practice Designer, I think. Okay, so this was the view that we designed yesterday. Okay, so yesterday there was some problem because my phone was not connecting, so you didn't see that, but now you can see the five icons and all these things. So this run is also complete, so we will see it there also. Okay, so this this is a text JD Vance, a struggling American in Times, and this is a logo actually. We want a three vertical dot, but this image is very big, so you have to use 24 dp size image, okay, for icon three vertical dot. Okay, and this icon is also very small, so yesterday we select the 18 dp, so you can use the 24 dp, then it will be little big. Okay, so there you can see the button is working fine, you can see the rounded corner too. Okay, so but in visual there is no rounded corner at all, so that means design is good. Okay. Now one thing I just want to do. Okay, so there I just show you some extra designs, okay, that you can implement, so it will look some. I just again try to add colors, then I will show you. Okay, so call the stroke, so solid or stroke, solid android color, some little light color. Okay, so just take this thing will be good. Take it. Okay, hope this will work. Okay, so now I want this in you see in first image I show you this. There is login form. Okay, so okay, so suppose you want this type of view where image is inside this edit text, okay, and this is there, so you can achieve this very easily. This is a little trick only. Okay, so for that one I have to put a icon, so let me check the size of 48 by 48. Oh, it is big. So what is this? So it is also big, so you can get, oh, we already have a small icon, so I just go to the project, I just pick some. So today's project name is login form, so I am going inside it and I am going putting some icon on their mipmap. Okay, so where is the download? Okay, so I think by growing no, we just put directly this account only. Okay, you will get this icon from material.io website. Okay. Okay, so I'm using these two. You have to use all the five combination of image, then it will do. Okay, so now come to the point. So this is my edit text, there I want a image inside this edit text box. So what I have to do, I have to write android drivable left or right. Okay, so which side you want the image? Okay, so right now I want this to be in left side. Okay. So the image name is account, so this is my image, and I want this to be little, or I want some margin between text and this image. So drivable padding, okay, so just use this padding as 5 dp. Okay, so let's have a I think this view is not refreshing. Okay, oh, now it become refreshed. Okay, so there you can see the account is there. Okay, let me again make it big. Okay, so if I want some extra space, so I will raise the padding there. Okay, so I will raise this padding size to be 10, so it become like that. Okay, so now do the same thing with the second edit text. So come inside Android drawable. So I want in same in left side, you can use right side also. So left side, what we have, second lock. Okay, so let where is lock, this is lock. Okay, and put Android padding, drawable padding, sorry, drawable padding. Okay, so again put 10 dp. network issue. No, my network is working fine. Oh. Okay, so now you got the view. Are you getting view? Press me. Okay. So this is it. Okay, so just once look at it again. Okay, so this is log. So come to this. Okay, so I will run. I don't run it. Okay, so just go to the Java code. Okay, so because you see the. Yeah, I will provide the copy of this video, and this code is uploaded on server. So I think you didn't see it. So just look at there. Blue App online class. Okay, go there. Select this one. Okay, so this is the previous batch or first batch of the Fidress Android course. So you have to go there, and inside there you can get the day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, and day 5. Okay, so I am providing 5 free lesson only. After that, if you want to continue this course, so you have to pay. Okay, so but till 5 lesson you can enjoy this course, and you can also download the code or watch the video. Everything is there. Okay, so whatever activity I'll do, it all there. Okay, so there is a button to download the complete code. So once you will click, so it will make the download. So this is for practice design. I put some images on this folder. This is a zip folder, and this is the outline file that I saw. So there you can find each everything. Okay. Okay, now come to the code. Okay, so now everything is ready. So what I want, when I click on button, submit button, I will get the value from this name field, okay, edit text, and from this phone number field, okay, edit text. So first we have to initialize all these things or declare everything. So we have two text view. First is for name, so I just use name, and second is for phone number, so use the variable name as phone. Okay. Now initialize it. So name is equal to, it is a edit view. So edit view. Okay. Find view by ID. So find. Show me the keyword. Okay. So find view by ID. R dot ID. Okay. So there you can see I put the ID as the text name, okay, and inside this phone number I put the ID as text phone, okay. So by the name of ID we call it, so txt phone or txt name, and for phone number, phone number is again edit text, so edit text. Now find view by ID, r dot ID is text phone. Okay, so one more important thing that I want to tell you, so whenever you call this r dot ID or r dot string or r dot layout, okay, so there you can see all this method is there. Oh, if you call r dot dimension or r dot ID or r dot string style, okay, whatever you will call, it will return a integer value. Okay, so it always return a integer value. So this method find view by ID always get a integer value. Okay, so this is correct. So sometime we call this r dot string or r dot ID for our use, so we have to convert it into a string. Okay, in the next video or maybe in today I will show you what it will be. Okay, so now I want a button. So button is submit button or login button. So button name is login for now. So login is equal to, this is the button type, so button. Find view by ID, okay, so r dot ID dot, the name of button is I think btn submit, let me check. Button is btn submit. Okay, so now, so I want on click event on my button. So whenever user click on button, so we will perform some task. So for that one we will put a listener on our button, so login dot set on click listener. Okay, so there you can see the first method is set on click listener, click it. Now inside it we have to provide this on click listener, so new on click listener, just click it, Android Studio will work for you. Okay, it will provide on click method too. Okay, so there you can write the code, here you can write, oh sorry. Okay, so when user click, so we want value from this edit text. Okay, so that means we are getting the value. Okay, so this is same as we pronounce, so get text, call the name and get text. Okay, and always use two string, so we want that text to be in string format, so because user can type integer value or floating value, all these things. So one thumb of rule is that never trust the user. Okay, so whenever you will create a app, so never trust on user, he can do anything. Okay, so name dot get text dot to string. Okay, so this is the string that we get. I am just storing it in a temporary string. Okay, so just use the name value. So So this way you can understand it easily. Otherwise I use the direct value to call all these things. So now phone number. So phone dot get text. Okay, so get text dot toString. Okay, so now the point is user can type 8-digit number, phone number, or he can type 10-digit number, correct number. Okay, so we have to validate the input values of users. Okay, so whatever you type. So suppose sometime user click login without typing any name or phone number, so we have to check it before we send this data to our other activity or do something with it. Okay, so for validating the data we have to use text utility. Okay, so this is the method, that text utility. Where it is, let me check. Text utilities. Okay, so this is the method we use. So if I want to check whether user has typed some name in this string or not in edit text, okay, so just check this string is empty or not. Okay, and same thing with this phone number. So use this text. I just okay, is empty, is empty. Okay, so there is the default method, and pass this name value, so it will tell you that this string is empty or not. Okay, so first we put a if condition. So now you understand how what I am going to do. So put a if this both name and phone value is non-empty, okay, then we will do something inside this if loop. Otherwise we will put else. Okay, we will show an error. So I just type show error. Okay, so what is this, remove all these things. Okay, come inside this if condition and type text utility dot is empty and provide first name, name value, and second both should be non-empty, so that's why use and operator. Okay, so text value again, or text utility again, is empty, and pass the phone number, small phone value. Okay, so that means if these two is non-empty, means user has typed something. So now the second thing is we have to cross check that phone number is 9-digit or 10-digit long or not, or user has just put 1 or 2-digit number there. Okay, so inside it there is again if condition. If you are expert in this looping, coding and condition, you can use other way also. There are so many ways to write this code. Okay, so I am just using a simplest code. So now what I am telling, okay, so now calculate the length of this phone number. So phone number dot length dot get should be greater than 9 or less than 11. Okay, phone number dot length should be less than 11. Okay, so greater than 9 means 10 and less than 11 means 10. Okay, so the number will be always be 10. So if this condition is also true, that means the name is valid and phone number is also valid. So now you are free to do anything. So if there, suppose phone number is less than 10 digits or not correct phone number, so you can show the error for phone number. Okay, so for showing the error, I just use another edit text. Okay, so maybe I can use the hint text to show the error to user. Okay, so I will change whenever this condition occurs, so I will change the hint and I will write it as like this. Phone, I just call the ID. Okay, phone number dot set hint. Okay, or I just write invalid number. Phone number. Okay. And if you require some extra, extra attention, so you can change that hint color text. Okay, so hint text color where is set hint, hint text color. Okay, so you can use it, make it a red, so red is for color code directly here. Always use the color dot string. So what is cannot resolve the, okay, so parse, it is the int. Okay, this is the string, we have to convert this into the color code. Okay, so parse integer dot parse, there is integer dot parse. So this is it. Okay, or if you use directly in color dot there. Okay, so if suppose I use color name is error color and put this code. Okay, so what I have to do, I just write there below it. Okay, so this way you can differentiate between these two conditions. So okay, so what I will call, I call r dot color dot, the name is the error color, so this it. Okay, so there you can see it is again showing the error. Okay, so what we have to do, actually this method phone dot set color text require a string. Okay, but this r dot color always return a integer value, so we have to convert it to string. So get string. Okay, so what is this? No, it requires not a string, it requires integer. Put parse underscore zero is ID. Okay, so resource dot, we have to call this method resource dot get color, then it will work. Get resource dot get color, then inside it put. So now you can see this is again depreciated method. Okay, so what is this saying? It is saying it is depreciated, so we have to change it. So leave it for now, you can search over it, so this is not a big deal. Okay, so this is how you can set a color, hint color. Okay, Okay, so and this is for showing the hint in inside the text view. Okay, there is another way. I will tell you the advanced UI when after this run. Okay, so but for now I am just going to use it. And in this condition, the main if else condition, I am using a directed text view. Okay, so this is all up to you. Either use the text view or direct show the hint inside this edit text. Okay, so I just want error text to be inside that. So just use the text view, wrap content, Android ID. So ID is error text. Okay, so not error text, that will be true. Error MSG, error message. Okay, so Android, I want text color to be red. So text color to be red. So we have, I think so. Control Z, what happened? Okay. Red color, and this to be in center. So gravity, layout gravity to be center, horizontal center. Okay, and one more thing, I don't want it to be display, so I can hide it. Okay, so initially I want this to be hide. So there you can select the visibility. So visibility will be gone, invisible and visible. Okay, so what happened, this is a visible means it will always be there. Okay, invisible means it will not be there, and gone is also means that it completely removed from the layout. Okay, so it will no longer present in this layout file. So use invisible because we want it there. Okay, so there you will see nothing but a space for this text view. Okay, so if I use gone, okay, so now you can see this space will be not there. Okay, so this is the difference between invisible and gone. Okay, okay, so now I want this error to be in text view, so I just use a text view quickly. Error text. Okay, and initialize it. Error text is equal to text view. Okay, find view by ID. Okay, r dot ID dot name is the error message. Okay, so what I will do, so suppose user type leave the name as empty, so I will show him the error. So name, my name is the error text dot first set the visibility as visible. So set visibility as use capital letter for writing inside it, because if you write simple visible, so it will not show you the pop-up method. So use capital letter. Okay, so visibility, so it will be view dot visibility. Okay, it will automatically get. So and so the error message. So now set text. Okay, invalid entry or invalid entry. Okay, so this is it. Okay, so now final thing. What I want after everything is okay, so he typed the name, phone number, and phone number is also valid. So I want it to be, or let him to be in my home screen. Okay, so home screen means my next activity. Okay, so for that one I want a new layout. So create a new layout file. So I just name it home screen. Okay, this is again a blank screen, so I just put a welcome message there. So use text view, wrap content, Android text is welcome to home. Android gravity, just put center, and Android text size to be 18 dp is enough. Okay, so this is it, don't do anything. Okay, so now I want we have to attach this layout with our a java file. Okay, so our java file is actually our activity, so I just use home screen. Always use same name for activity and layout file. Okay, otherwise in big project you will get confused about activity and layout files. Okay, so this is it. So just copy the onCreate method. Okay, so this is it. Now get it. OnCreate method is the entry point for every activity. So just change the layout. Our new layout will be home screen. Okay. So one more thing that we have to do, we have to explain to the our Android OS that there is another activity in my app. Okay. So use a activity tag. Okay. So there you can see, once you click activity it will pop up you. So basically it is, once you create this activity and you use this extend app compatibility activity, so Android Studio make indexing for that one and make it as a activity. Okay, so there you can find easily get it, and just close this tag. Okay, so right now we don't want this intent or other things, I will tell you in later. Okay, so this is it. Now the task is, when user click on this button, we have to move user into the next activity or in next screen. So for that one we have to use intent. Okay, so intent is a very useful, just type the keyword intent. Okay, so to start a new activity or to start a new function or other apps, we always use this intent. Okay, so the purpose of this intent is to communicate between two activities or between two apps. Okay, so we can pass some parameter using intent also. So first I will show you how to create activity. Okay, so just initialize the intent variable. Okay, so intent is equal to new intent. Okay, so there what we have to pass, so there you can see we have to pass the context. Context means a reference point. This is the context. Okay, so I use this word, or this is a keyword actually. Okay, so this context always make a reference point of your current activity. Okay, so suppose I am in this activity and I am using context or this, so I just write the keyword. All meaning of this, all keyword are same. Okay, you can use this. Okay, or you can use get application context. Okay, or you can directly use context. Sometimes in method you get context as a parameter. Okay, I will show you after few days. Okay, so this and this things all is same. Okay, it give you the reference point of your main activity. Okay, so right now I am using, or one more thing, or you can use like that only. So call your main activity name and put dot this, so this is also refer as the context. Okay, Okay, so where I was, okay, so now our task is to start a new activity. Okay, so for that one, intent, your first activity name and your next activity name, so where you want user to be redirect. Okay, so use the activity name is home and put dot class. Okay, this is it, and final thing is start that activity. So start activity, okay, call this it and pass this variable intent there. That's it. Okay, so once everything is okay, user click on this login button, and inside it, when it go inside it, it will move to the next home screen. Okay, so once I will run it, then we will move further. You can use this set on click listener in text view also, in image view also. Okay, so this is ready. Just so if suppose there will be error, so it will display on log page. Oh, I forget to write the log. So okay, after that this run I will create a log. Okay, okay, so there you can see edit text button. Okay, so I just click login without typing anything. So let's see what happens. Okay, so app is crashed, so that means there is some problem. Okay, so just go there. What is it? Okay, so actually I have to again click on run. So wait. I just run from device only. So what is the name of project is login form. So L. So there is it. Okay. So just select this. So there one more thing that I want to tell you about it. So if you want only error will be displayed there, okay, so you can select this error log only, so it will show you the only red line, but whenever you write the log.e that will be displayed there. Okay, so sometime you see this log cat is continuously showing the lines, new lines. Okay, so what you have to do, first you have to click on your running app. So right now in my device there is two app is running. Okay, so this is our app, so just click on it. Okay, and one more thing that you have to do, so only selected application. Okay, so if I put no filter, so you can see it, so all the log that generated by the other app or networks, all these thing will be there. So if I suppose select the E, so I will see all the red signal. Okay, this is the network call. So okay, so this is it. So now I am going to click on my button, so then we will see this is it. Okay, so there you can see number format exceptional null pointer. Okay, so what is this color dot parse? I think so. That means, let me color dot parse color. Okay, so I think this will work. And anything else? Okay, one more thing that, okay, so you can see, so is empty, it already inside this field. Now it has to be in there, so there is some problem I think. So I just put log. Okay, so this way we can track each line. Okay, r dot log dot e, and there provide the name as main activity comma and main. Okay, so just use it. Okay, so once it will insert means on click. Okay, so on click inside if condition, main if condition. Okay, there is a number condition, so valid phone. Okay, so there is a invalid phone. This is how you can troubleshoot your problems. So whenever you get and main else condition. Okay, so this way we track where we are getting problems. And okay, so click on again. Oh, actually I put wrong condition. Actually this should be not empty and not empty, because when I click on login button without typing anything, this condition is true actually. So don't worry. Okay, so now click on login. So there you can see on click main if condition invalid phone number. So definitely it is invalid. There I have to put if not empty and if not empty. Okay, then it will be work. So if number is not empty, then it will go inside it, otherwise go there only. Okay, so click on it. Oh, so there you can see. I just zoom it. What is this? So there you can see invalid entry. Okay. Let me select. Okay. And if I put some name, I am typing name and click on again login button. Okay, so what happens? There should be invalid. Let me click by. Okay, so main inside else on click. just want to remove. Okay, on click main else condition. Okay, so yes, this is true because both should not be non-empty. Okay, so that's why it is going inside the else condition. So now the time to type some number there. So now I am going to click there. So on click main if condition, but phone number is invalid. So now it is inside this if condition. Okay. So name and phone number is non-empty, but the length is not correct. So this is it. Okay. So one more thing that I want to show you. What happened when I So there you can see hint message. So when I click on it, okay, edit text. So there you see the number letters, okay. But it is a phone field, and you have to show the user the numbers only, okay. So what you can do, you can define the input type in your edit text, okay. So now come to there. So there the property name as a input type, okay, input type. So there you can see you want date type or number or decimal number, password number, password, phone, simple text, yeah, auto complete text is if suppose user type incorrect sentence, then it will be corrected automatically. If you want text password, that will be in asterisk mark, okay, whenever you type, so it will show your asterisk, so you have to use this. So there are so many things. There is email address, web address, okay. So this is the thing. So what phone number is the phone number, so this is it. Or either you can use number because some user type plus or other things. So you can use this thing, okay. So this is about this login form. So I just make a quick entry and I will show you next home screen, okay. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, okay. So now I'm going to click on login. So there you can see welcome to home screen, okay. Okay, so now the second thing that I told you in starting of this session, that we will work on some material design also. So look at this form. Actually, no, not this form. There is no thing. Okay, so let me explain you. So in some app, you have see that there is a text box. Okay, so when you click on it, so that this hint text will move up to this position, okay. So to achieve this type of edit text, we have to use a library, okay. So come inside this Gradle file. We have to use a design library actually, okay. Okay, so just make some space. Whenever you will change it, change in this file, okay. So there will be option after when I do. So there will be option name as a sync, okay. So you have to click on sync button always. Otherwise, your app will not work or your Android Studio will not let you do anything. Oh, it is taking time. What happened? Just wait, once it will give me access, I will show you. Okay, so we have to use the design library. Okay, so support design library, the name is the support design library, so just copy it. So the name is design, so design. Okay, and we have to pass the version name. So version name will always be your SDK version. Okay, so your target version is right, my target version is right now 24. Okay, and there you can see my app compatibility version is 24.2.1. so you have to use the same version, otherwise it will create a error. Okay, or show you the error that the version is not correct. Okay, so once you make change on this file, okay, click on this button, sync now. Okay, so just click on it. Wait. You have to put all your dependency or library file inside this dependency tag. Okay, so and one more thing, don't use this build.gradle, this is for project only. Okay, use the this module gradle file only. So put your dependency there. Taking time. Okay, so now it is ready. Okay. So come to our XML file, we don't need it anymore. Okay, so I am just going to change one edit text. Okay, so I just change this one, this text view. Okay, so to get the appearance that when you click on edit text, so the text will be move up. Okay, so for that one we have to use Android support library, okay, support wizard, oh sorry, widget, Android, okay, so there you will want to see, okay, so widget, I want to add text, input text, okay, so this is it. Don't use edit text, use the input layout, okay, so you have to provide the all these values, so wrap content or use the match parent, whatever you want, hide to be wrap content, okay, so just use the margin left, because once I will put this inside, so its margin will not work anymore, okay, so put your edit text inside input layout, okay, there, okay, this is it. There is nothing to do with it, okay, so just try to run this code, and we have hint as the type name, okay, so when I will select this one, so this text will be move up, okay, so now it is ready, so
Okay.
So actually I use wrap container something, and this is the text actually. Where is, oh sorry, I think I missed this design. Okay, so first I just want to remove it. Okay. Android, the color of text will be text. Text color hint is this one, and text color is this one. Okay, hint ID layout layout, and this will be wrap content. wrap content, all these things. Okay, so this is the last thing that you have to put your edit text inside this text input layout. Okay, so it will work like material design. So do you have any other questions for today's session? What's going on? So inside it there is no hint text, I think. Oh, so there you can see. Okay, got it. So type name, so basically this is a hint that go up there, but because the main layout size is width is very less, so that's why it is not showing by default. So if I just use 150 or 120 dp, okay, and this field also be 150 dp, so then it will be so. Okay, because what happened, the wrap content size is zero, that's why it is not showing. Otherwise it is there, always is there. So there you can see. default is there. So now you can see when I click on it, so this move up, okay. So actually this edit text is for full width, not for like that name and text, that's why. So if I have to manually define this width, so you can do your customization, okay. So this is for today's session and I will meet you in next session, okay. So okay, bye.